Good morning, Saints. I hope you are all well and thank God that you are still alive. God is a good God. He has kept us right through this season. Shall we close our eyes and pray? Thank you, Lord, for this awesome day. We thank you for your love, for your goodness, Lord, for your faithfulness. Bless the reading of the word today. It will not go back to you void. Thank you that it will find a place in our hearts and that it will impact our lives. All the honor, Lord, and all the glory belongs to you. We thank you, Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. I will hand over to Sister Angel, who will read the Psalms for us. Amen.
Morning, brothers and sisters. I'll be reading from Psalms 100. The Lord says to my Lord, sit at my right hand until I make your enemies a footstool for your feet. The Lord will extend your mighty scepter from Zion, saying, rule in the midst of your enemies. Your troops will be wheeling on your day of battle. Arrayed in holy splendor, your young men will come to you like dew from the morning's womb. The Lord has sworn and will not change his mind. You are a priest forever in the order of Melchizedek. The Lord is at your right hand. He will crush kings on the day of his word. He will judge nations, heaping up the dead and crushing the rulers of the whole earth. He will drink from a brook along the way, and so he will lift his head high. Amen. Get your notebook, pen, and get ready to receive the word of God from our man of God, Pastor Ricardo.
Well, praise God. Welcome to our broadcast this morning. We are so honored to have you join us this morning. We are very excited as next week, Sunday, you'll be able to join us in a live recording, a live broadcast of our service at our auditorium, which is now ready for us to come back together again and worship the Lord together in fellowship. Praise God. Hallelujah. And if you are in the Newcastle area, the details are appearing on your screen. Please connect with us. Send us a WhatsApp and register for our services. As you know, currently we are limited to a maximum of 50 people in our facilities. So it's very important that you register and you let us know that you're coming so that we can make provision and welcome you. Amen. Praise God. And we are situated at number 3 Bridges Street, which is situated in the CBD in the heart of Newcastle. So you're most welcome to join us. Amen. That's next week, Sunday. Starting from next week, Sunday, we'll be live. Amen. Praise God. And this morning, thank you so much to Sister Dolly and Sister Angel for opening up in prayer and sharing a very inspirational psalm with you. Before we share God's precious word. And I trust this morning that you've got your pens, your notebook, most importantly, your Bible ready as we share God's precious word. And I want to share with you about salvation this morning. And we all know in the book of Romans, the first chapter and verse number 16, Paul writes to the church at Rome, and he says, for I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone who believes. Praise God. So our believing is very important. Our believing sets things right for us in the message of the gospel of Jesus Christ. And I want to share something in the book of Philippians with you, chapter number 2. And I want to read from verse number 12. And the entire book of Philippians, it's a book of great joy that Paul shares with the church at Philippi. And that is the joy that we as Christians have, the joy of the Lord, which is our strength. That means whatever you're facing, whatever you're going through in life, You have this unspeakable joy, and that's the main theme of the book of Philippians that Paul shares with the church at Philippi, and he shares with you and I today. But I want to share with you from verse number 12, the second chapter, and Paul writes to the church at Philippi, and he says, "Therefore, my beloved, as you have always obeyed, not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence." You see that? "As you have always obeyed, not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. For it is God who works in you both to will and to do for his good pleasure." Praise God. That's the life of the Christian. And that's what Paul was saying. "Not that I've been present with you that you obey, but much more in my absence. Because what you do in my absence is more important." And the life of a Christian, I would like to liken it to the life of an apprentice. An apprentice learns from a master. In other words, if you are an apprentice electrician, you would be put under a master electrician to learn the trade. And that is what Paul was sharing with the church at Philippi, and that is what it is for us as Christians. We learn from the Master Jesus Christ, and he has ordained for us apostles, prophets, pastors, teachers, and evangelists to equip us as Christians for the work of the ministry, for the work of the gospel, the work of Christ Jesus. And Paul says, now much more in my absence, because when I'm not there, you've got to work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. Praise God. Now, very importantly, what he says, he does not say work for your salvation. You see that? He doesn't say work for your salvation, because we are not saved by our own works. It is the grace of God, by the grace of God, through faith in Christ Jesus, that we are saved, not by our own good works, as the Bible says, lest any man should boast. So our own works could never save us. It is the grace of God, it is the works of the saving grace of God and faith in Christ Jesus that saves us. So that is how we are saved. And that is how we receive salvation, is through faith in Christ Jesus, not by our good works. So Paul says, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. So Paul says, work out. So what must you work out? You work out what is in you. Many years ago, I think there was an advert that was made by Cremora. And they would, it was a husband and wife. And you find that the husband gets upset and he says, "There's no Cremora in the refrigerator." And then you hear the woman screaming in the back. The wife says, "It's not inside, it's on top." But I'm here to tell you this morning that it's not on the outside of you. It's not on the top. Cremora lied to you. It is in you. Paul says, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. Jesus says, "He who believes in me from deep within his being will flow rivers of living waters." And that is the waters of salvation. The word salvation, friends, means it's a Greek word translated soteria. Soteria means to be healed. It means to be saved. It means to be delivered. Praise God. So Paul is saying, work out your own salvation, your healing, your saving, your deliverance. Work it out with fear and trembling. You know, I'd like to liken it to this bean seed. I've got a bean seed in my hand here. And if you look at a bean seed, You don't really see everything that is actually in it. And what do you do with it? You take a bean seed and you go and sow it in the ground. And after you've sown it, what do? Every day you've got to gradually water it. I think many of the kids in our schools, they do this bean seed project. And they are to take it and they put some cotton wool and you put it in a little jar and you got to put some soil behind it and you water it daily, and day by day you record the gradual development and growth process of the bean seed. And, you know, so it is with your salvation. So it is with your salvation. You don't see it. You may not be able to see it on the outside, but God has sown it. He has done a work in you. He has done it in your heart, in your spirit. And gradually, day by day, you spend time studying the Word of God. You spend time in the presence of God praying. You spend time listening to men and women of God preaching anointed sermons to you so that you can grow in your faith and you can grow. And this gift of salvation begins to grow on the inside of you. You begin to grow and you begin to grow in the things of God and you begin to change, just like this bean seed, that day by day, you know, you grow it and then you see that change taking place. And so it is with the Word of God. And so it is with our salvation. God has placed it deep within your heart and now it is there. So your salvation, it encompasses everything you need for this glorious life that you've received in Christ Jesus. It includes your forgiveness of your sins. It includes your deliverance from bad habits or bad living. It includes your healing from sicknesses and diseases. So your salvation, the salvation that you've received, it means to be saved, to be healed, and to be delivered. Praise God. It encompasses all things. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Now, this morning, I want to share with you, Paul says, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling, for it is God who works in you both to will and to do according to his good pleasure. So it is God that is at work in you. It is God in the salvation. It is God that is working. I'm reminded of the account where Jesus speaking to Philip. Philip asked, show us the Father. And he says, have I been with you so long that you ask us to show, that you ask me to show you the Father? He says, the words I speak to you, I speak not by my own authority, but the Father in me does the works. Praise God. So, friends, it is God working in you. God is working daily in you. And you've got to rely on the strength of God. You've got to rely on the ability of God. And it is God that works in you both to will. You find now that you've been born again, now that you've been saved, now that you're a child of God, you do not have your own will now. You surrender your will to his will. And you find very often God prompts you into his will. He doesn't force you. He prompts you gently. He causes you to walk in accordance with his will. He prompts you to do according to what he desires you to do. And that is how God works in you. It is God who works in you both to will and to do according to his good pleasure. You'll find very often the Lord will prompt you to do something that you think, you know, is beyond your natural reasoning and it's beyond your understanding. And you find that just your obedience to that, just your obedience to that voice, it's the voice of God. As you read the Word of God, you find God will speak to you, prompt you to do something. And it may not make sense at that point in time, but that's the glory and the beauty of it all, is that your salvation you receive by faith, and now you are not going by what you see, but you're going by faith. The Bible says the just shall live by faith. Praise God. Hallelujah. It's like the man that the disciples of Jesus asked him. They said, Lord, who sinned that this man was born blind? Was it his mother, his father, or did he sin? And Jesus said, no, neither this man, nor his mother, nor his father sinned, but that the works of God may be made manifest in him, was he born this way. And then you find that Jesus spat on the ground, made some clay with his spit, and with that soil, anointed the eyes of the man, and sent him to go and wash his face in the pool of Siloam. And the Bible says the man came back seeing. Praise God. So you find very often God will prompt you to do something that doesn't make sense, the life you live now, you don't live by what you see. You live purely by faith. And it's God that will prompt you to walk and move by faith. You'll start doing things in faith. And friend, it's very important that when God prompts you to do something, take that step and do it. Hallelujah. Take that step and do it. Because it's where you take that step of faith, that is where God steps in. You see that? Where you take your step of faith, God steps in and God takes over and God does the work. It is God who works in you both to will and to do. So God will cause you to do something. The Lord will cause you to do something, lead you to do something. And as you are obedient to it, as Paul was speaking to the church at Philippi, and he says, as you have obeyed always, not just in my presence, but much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. You see that? So now you find that God now will prompt you to do something. And as he prompts you to do something, that is his will. It's because God, when God desires to do something or to manifest something in your life, he will prompt you to do something that is beyond your reasoning, beyond your understanding, beyond what you can see. So don't go by what you can see, what you can feel, touch, or hear, but go by faith that when God speaks, you obey what God has said. And you take that step of faith, and then you find God takes over, and God does the work, and God perfects it. And you find it's all for his pleasure. It is not for our pleasure. It is for his pleasure alone. Let me read what the Message translation of the scripture that I just shared with you, what the Message Bible says. He says, what I'm getting at, friends, is that you should simply keep on doing what you have done from the beginning. In other words, be consistent. When I was living among you, you lived in responsive obedience. There's always a response. Respond in faith to God. Respond in faith to what God is prompting you to do. Now that I'm separated from you, keep it up. Better yet, redouble your efforts. In other words, do everything possible to work this thing out, to make it work for you. Hallelujah. Be energetic in your life of salvation. Be energetic in your life of salvation. What he's saying is, don't be lazy. Hallelujah. A lazy man, the Bible says, will not eat, will not enjoy the benefits. So with the salvation that you've received, with your faith, don't be lazy. Be energetic in your life of salvation, reverent and sensitive before God. That energy, watch this, that energy is God's energy, an energy deep within you, God himself willing and working at what will give him the most pleasure. Hallelujah. I believe that God wants to work through somebody this morning. I believe God wants to work through you this morning. God wants to do something through you. Amen. Whenever God wants to do something in the earth, the human being is a vessel, a conduit through which God will work and manifest his power through. And I believe that God will work through you this morning. I believe he'll work through you in this time and in this season that we are in. And this is glorious. This is not your power. This is not your energy. This is God's power. This is God's energy. Hallelujah. Praise God. In other words, we are living in the overflow of God's saving grace. And as we allow his salvation, we allow his grace, and we allow his spirit to work through us, we find that it is not just for us, but it flows out of us and it affects the lives of everybody around us. That's why we find in verse 14, Paul goes on to say, do everything readily and cheerfully. No bickering. No second guessing allowed. In other words, don't second guess this thing. Be fully convinced about it. Don't second guess. Don't question it. Just do it. Hallelujah. He says, go out into the world uncorrupted, a breath of fresh air in the squalid and polluted society. Hallelujah, a breath of fresh air. The book of 1 Corinthians 15 says, the first Adam, he was a living being. He became a living being. But the second Adam, Jesus Christ, became a life-giving spirit. You have received in you abundant life. It's the life of God. Allow that life to flow out of you. Allow that life to work in you. Praise God. Hallelujah. Let that life work. And you'll find that as you do so, people will get healed. Yes, there'll be healings. What did Jesus say? He says, he who believes, those who believe in me, these things will follow them in my name. Hallelujah. They'll cast out demons and devils. They'll lay hands on the sick and have them recover. Praise God. Those who believe, it is not just for pastors. It is not just for the fivefold ministry giftings that have been given to the body of Christ. It is for every child of God. You can lay hands on the sick and have them recover. This is the abundant life we have in Christ Jesus. Don't let the devil rob you. Don't hold court cases in your mind, whether you can do it or whether you can't do it. Don't hold cases and say, when I consider the circumstances and I look at the facts, don't go by facts. The Bible didn't call us. God didn't call us to go by the facts. He called us to go by faith. He called us to live by the truth of his word, because it's his word that sets us free. I may be speaking to someone this morning. I don't know what you're going through, but when you consider it and you consider the report that you have, it could be a lawyer's report. It could be a doctor's report. It could be a report from your creditors. But I'm here to tell you that Christ Jesus came to give you life and life in abundance. Don't go by the facts, but go by the truth of God's word. Go into the word. See what the word of God says concerning that situation that you are facing. And hold a court case now. Now you hold a court case. Don't just hold a court case with what they have told you and look at that report. No, take that report. Put it on the left-hand side of you. And then you take the word of God and you line it up with what you've received, with the report that you've received. And now you have your court case, because God's truth, the truth sets you free. That is what the Bible says. You will know the truth and the truth will set you free. So you believe the report of the Lord God. Hallelujah. Isaiah 53. Believe the report of the Lord God Almighty. Don't believe what you see. Don't go by what you see. Go by the word of God. What has God said in his word? And you see the truth of God's word. And then you line it up with that thing. And then all of a sudden you take it and you say, Satan, in the name of Jesus, I give you notice today. The word of God has set me free. I am healed by the word of God. I am saved by the word of God. I'm delivered by the word of God. It could be somebody, you probably have an addiction. Listen, take that thing and throw it out of the way. That is not you. You are who this word says you are. You have what this word says you have. You can do what this word says you can do. Hallelujah. Praise God. Glory to God. Rise up to your feet today and start dancing and rejoice for all that the Lord has done for you. It's all in his word. Go for the word and nothing else. Hallelujah. So work out your salvation. Let the salvation that you've received, once it's there in your heart. Begin to work it out. Faith is there in your heart. Begin to work it out. Don't sit on it. Don't sit and wait. Don't be idle. There's no time for idleness. Otherwise, you'll be like that man that was sitting by the pool of Bethesda, waiting for the waters to be stirred. The waters were stirred, and everybody else jumped in before him. He never received nothing. Jesus asked him, do you want to be made well? He starts making excuses. So what's your excuse this morning? Stop making excuses. Hallelujah. That's my word to you from today. Stop making excuses. The waters have been stirred. It's time for you to jump into those waters. It's time for you to be healed. It's time for you to be delivered. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. It's time for you to be saved. If you don't know the Lord Jesus, you haven't received him as your personal Lord and Savior, Let me tell you, friend, you're going straight to hell. Hallelujah. Now, there's a second opportunity for you to make a turnaround and make a comeback and make Jesus Lord and Savior of your life. Jump into this pool, the pool is being stirred. The salvation pool is being stirred. Jump into the pool and receive Jesus this morning as your Lord and Savior. Hallelujah. And if that's you this morning, you don't know Jesus, you want to know him and you want to receive him, I want to encourage you this morning to join me and receive the Lord Jesus. The Bible says there is no other name given among men by which men might be saved except the name of Jesus. So you can receive Jesus this morning as your personal Lord and Savior. Let us pray together. Just close your eyes and repeat the simple prayer of faith with me as we pray together. And just receive Jesus. Receive life. Receive your life back this morning. Take back your life this morning. Hallelujah. Don't let the enemy rob you. Don't let him rob you. Don't let him steal it from you. You take it back this morning. Take it by force. Praise God. Heavenly Father, I come to you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, according to your word. If I shall confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus and believe with all of my heart that God raised him from the dead, I shall be saved. Right now, Lord Jesus, I open the door of my heart to you. I ask you to come into my heart and be my personal Lord and Savior. I receive your free gift of eternal life. And I thank you right now that from this moment on, I am washed in your precious blood. From this moment on, I am saved in Jesus' mighty name. Amen, amen, praise God, hallelujah. Welcome to the family of God. If you've prayed that prayer, I want to welcome you into the family of God. And the details are appearing on the screen. Connect with us, write to us, send us a text, WhatsApp, an email. We love to hear from you. And most importantly, it's very important, wherever you are, connect with a church. Find a local church in your local area where you can grow in your newfound faith in Christ Jesus and begin to work out your salvation. Praise God. Work out what God has worked in you. The Bible says when God created man, he breathed into his life the breath of life. And man became a living being. And I just shared with you earlier on, the first Adam became a living being. The second Adam, Jesus Christ, became a life-giving spirit. Now you have life and you have life in abundance. Don't let the enemy rob you of that. Amen. Hold on to this life and walk in the light of it, in the truth of it. Praise God. Until next time, this is Pastor Ricardo. As you stretch your hands towards the screen as I release the blessing. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. The Lord cause his face to shine upon you. The Lord God Almighty grant you special favors and great success in Jesus' blessed name. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth and the love of God and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with you both now and forevermore in Jesus' blessed name. God's people said, amen, amen. This is Pastor Ricardo saying, we love you very much. Looking forward to seeing you next week. Number 3, Bridger Street. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Keep walking by faith.